Hello, everybody, and welcome back to a little bit different of a Spelunky run today. Once again, I am joined by Dr. Brian, aka Lorgon111.
How you Spelunky! Doing?
Hooray! And last time you saw the two of us playing Spelunky, we were doing a head-to-head daily challenge, and I thought it might be kind of fun to try doing that in the opposite direction, where we're actually helping each other through each level and kind of communicating what we're running across and stuff like that. And I had mentioned maybe we could do it for another daily, and then Brian came up with the idea that
we would use Frozlunky. So there's a tool called Frozlunky, which lets you use your own seeds, so that rather than playing the daily, you can just get a seeded world, and as a result, both people are playing in the same world and have the same loot in the crates or whatever, but as a result, it won't affect our daily challenge scores.
Exactly, because Brian pointed out it might be a little bit cheaty if we're trying to help each other through a daily challenge and we're able to point out where all the good loot is and stuff like that. So
right, but yeah, I think it'll be interesting to be able to kind of, yeah, tell each other, warn each other about things that are coming up and whatnot.
Yeah, we'll see how long it takes us to get to Yama and beat him and everything. So we'll definitely do that this time. We were just kidding last time.
So we've
been doing a little bit of testing out and making sure that the seeds are correct and doing some Spelunky science so far, and it's been kind of interesting. And I think we're ready to get into this. Are you?
I think so. I'm ready to resume game whenever you are.
All right, 3, 2, 1, resume.
Woohoo!
So one thing we ran across in our testing is that at first, crates were not properly seated because I had gotten a bomb box in one and Brian had only gotten a bomb bag. So we realized that was due to differences in versions of Frozlunky. And then we've also noticed that pots do not seem to be fully seated, so we'll get different things in pots, but those are less critical, I'd say.
Indeed. Yeah, so long as we're getting the same loot and crates and have the same layout of the mines and whatnot, it seems like this will be good. Okay, there's spikes when you fall down below.
Yes, I was just going to tell you that as well. Thankfully, neither of us found it out the hard way.
That's right.
And then there's a spider when you jump up to the next ledge.
Yeah.
And then a spider further ahead as well. And Damsel Doggy, he might be in a rescuable position down there.
At a glance, it looks like we'll be able to get him.
Finagle our way around there a little bit.
Do you have random damsels, or do you have Damsel Doggy?
I have Damsel Doggy right now.
I see, alright.
I figured it would be fitting.
Hooray!
I usually go with little Slothbert, but I figured Damsel Doggy would be the most appropriate for today.
That's very happy, I'm glad you did that.
Alright, I am at the exit, nothing untoward happened. Nothing
really
worth mentioning.
Yep, I am too. I'm picking up a rock. I'm walking out the door.
So I'm curious, I've got 2,800. How much did you pick up there?
I have 4,000, but again, I guess we probably got different gems and pots or whatever.
Oh, that could be. Did you invest any ropes? Because there were a few places where I could have gotten some gems.
I did not.
Okay. Interesting. Okay. Are you ready to press on?
Yes.
All right. 3, 2, 1, go.
There is an arrow trap to the right.
Indeed. And I've got a ruby down to the left, and then Damsel Doggy.
I'm going to leave behind.
He might be hanging out for the rest of the day there.
That's right. He looks like he's in a safe spot. We want to leave him safe.
He's all warm and cozy. There's no reason to move him. I don't know how he got himself into a place encased by wall, but...
It would be interesting to see, the prehistory of Damsel Dog.
Why is he always wandering around, and why does he get himself trapped in hard-to-reach places? Why does he do what he does? All right. Do we rob the shop or not? It's got two bombs, a box.
So that's usually my criteria for yes. It is early, but this many bombs seems like a good.
I'm basically the same way, and obviously a jetpack would be kind of a shoe-in. All right. So I'm doing my tried and true robbing method. Worked out my charm. Oh, and there's climbing gloves in that mystery box. I wonder if you're gonna get the same thing for the mystery box.
I got climbing gloves.
Okay. Cool.
So yeah, I presume shops and whatever are the same. Okay, there's the idol over there, which doesn't seem worth it.
I was tempted for that, but then I realized we're not doing a daily, so it's more about how far can we get.
I guess trying to get far in survivability sounds good, and I can't really see enough over to the right, but I'm probably going to move forward.
I moved forward already.
Okay.
So we've got a lot of bombs, we've got a shotgun. Looking pretty good early game, I'd say.
Yep.
Oops, I went ahead and moved on without even thinking about it, and there's a shop right...
Oh boy.
Are you playing?
Yeah, I'm playing.
So, I'm not a big fan of this. I'm thinking of maybe investing some bombs along the left-hand side to get a clear shot at him.
That's a good idea.
I'm going to Yeah, it might even take some ropes as well. I think I'm gonna do it. Is this the right way to go? I don't know. I don't know how, I mean, you could probably drop in there quickly and shoot at him before he gets a chance to retaliate, but I don't really want to risk it.
Yeah, I'm using three bombs to clear out the landscape in front so I can get a clear shot.
Yep, and I'm hanging down from a rope and I killed him dead. And I still, okay, so the shopkeeper at the end is still running around apparently, judging by the music.
This guy does not want to walk back towards the shop. He's hanging out right at the edge.
On the right-hand side, past the shop, there he is. A bomb bag. Crap. Uh-oh.
Okay, I got him.
Okay. I'm going to bomb my way through to the right at the back of the shop, because there's some stuff I see.
I see, yeah. Oops, I forgot that I don't have paste yet, and so I just wasted a bomb.
Oh,
okay.
Yep, I do that every once in a while. So there was a bomb bag and some ropes, and there's another crate we could get to, but it would take some bombing. I don't think anything else back there is worth it. Lots of TNT in this level, I'm seeing.
Indeed.
And then when you do head down finally towards Damsel Doggy, there's a scorpion patrolling. Be wary. Damsel Doggy's in a nice, safe little area.
Alright, so let's see. Yeah, can't... I'm gonna get to this other crate that you didn't open up.
Okay.
Just to... see what is there.
Because we do have quite a few bombs at this point.
Yeah, and so we can kind of divide and conquer or whatever. I can tell you if it's worth it. And you can tell me. Okay, it was just ropes.
Okay.
More ropes. So I've got a dozen ropes now.
Hooray for ropes. There are a number of arrow traps so far, but nothing that should catch you by surprise, I don't think.
Okay, that's good.
The shopkeeper is not in a wonderful position at the end, though, so I'm not looking forward to that.
Okay, I'm going to need to speed things up because I've been a little slow.
Oh, true.
Here.
Holy cow. That went fast. That's what happens when you're trying to pay attention and take your time. Yeah, I don't know exactly how I want to go about this shopkeeper at the end. I'm going to have to make up my mind quickly, though.
I'm going to bomb him from above since I'm still back over here.
Oh, yeah, and we don't have sticky paste. Now, sometimes they do manage to jump out, which scares me to no end. Okay, I dropped a bomb, but it did not get him. And we've got the ghost now. Oh, boy. Oh, I don't like where this is going. Oh, okay.
Okay, my bomb did get him.
Good. He ran out and landed on spikes, so now I just have to avoid the ghost and get back around.
Right. Now I just have to avoid the ghost and get back around as well.
okay.
Got the ghost.
Come up here.
Damsel Doggy, why don't you go drop down there somewhere, please?
All right. I think... Ooh, I'm going to have to use... Can I... Oh, yeah. I have climbing gloves. All right. I made it to the exit.
I made it to the exit as well.
Did you rescue Damsel Doggy?
I did rescue Damsel Doggy.
I did not remember to do that, unfortunately.
Yeah, I mean, fortunately, basically, you scattered out the level for me, so I just took the shortcut.
You ready to press on here?
I am ready to press on. 3, 2, 1, go.
All right. Some gold off to the immediate right and a giant spider so we can get that paste.
Terrific.
Although it was pretty handy not having it last time.
Kind of. Oh, I just took some damage from the spider because I'm a dummy.
Oh, I had a head-to-head run with Fabe recently because the Spelunky group I'm in, we were trying to do a tournament, and I met a very untimely end because of Giant Spider, and I haven't done that in the longest time. And
I felt see. Very yeah, spiders, ashamed of it. Giant Spiders still get me somewhat frequently. Okay, I'm kind of heading down to the next area. Okay, that arrow trap's already gone off.
Damsel Doggy would take some bombs to get to off on the right, and I see we do have the chest
locked
here.
Locked chest, right.
Haven't seen the key just yet. I'll just move that forward a little bit, little by little. Yeah, still not seeing the key. I hope it's not off to the right or something.
I'll tell you if I see it.
We've got a vault here, bottom left. Okay, it's over on the right. There's a pushable block that you can use to get to it. And it'll take a rope to... Oh, no, it won't take a rope to get out because we have climbing gloves. Gotta remember that.
Nope. Oh, goodness. I might need to go after Damsel Doggy. I just took some more damage.
Oh, boy. What are you at heart-wise
I'm
right
at
now?
3 hearts now.
Okay, I'm at 5 still. I guess you took the spider damage.
Yeah.
All right, so I'm going to set off some arrow traps down on the bottom and then try to position myself for the shopkeeper. I haven't quite seen where he is yet, which worries me. Just going to edge my way out there. There's a couple different mobs down here at the bottom of the level. Oh, okay, I found him. And just did a shotgun blast and apparently angered him, so I'm gonna be shooting from the distance here. And there's that vault keeper, so I don't know if the guys are dead yet or not. Please be dead yet. I see the shotgun. Okay, I secured the exit.
Okay, so when you said the guys, was there a shop as well as the
final
shopkeeper?
No, just the vault keeper and then the exit keeper.
Right, okay. The exit keeper.
Sounds a little more epic when you say it that way.
Right.
None shall pass.
Okay, and I can see the shopkeeper. Yeah, you can shoot him from a long distance away, it looks like. So.
Yeah, if you stand on that block that's
next
to spikes.
Yeah, that one block, the covering, yeah.
Mm-hmm. It gives you pretty straight shot to him. All right, so I'm sitting in the exit, waiting for my partner.
All right, I'm firing at the shopkeeper from long range.
All right. We are definitely taking a lot longer on each level than I would have expected.
Because
that was just about ghost timing for me.
Needing to communicate or whatever. Okay, yeah. So I need to rescue Damsel Doggy too. Okay, so let's grab Damsel Doggy.
Oh, man,
Damsel
I keep
Doggy
forgetting to do that.
Well, he had to use a bomb and I was in more fire team, so... Okay, but I made it to the exit.
All right.
Completed the mines. We have our Ujet Eye. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we've got everything we need.
Yep.
Moving on to the jungle. 3, 2, 1, go.
Sounds good.
All right, let's see if we get lucky with the black market. Okay, a bunch of spikes right off the bat. Not the most fun.
I'll let you go that way. I'm going to cheese it and bomb down through.
Play it safe. I still have 26 bombs
also
at this point.
Just kind of divide and conquer and try to move quickly. I still have 22 bombs.
Oh, that's pretty good. Okay, Frog, you are not going to be able to get to me. Lots of tiki traps, but I guess then again it is the jungle. It's kind of what the jungle does. And I think I'm going to spend a bomb on the tiki trap that's kind of preventing downward motion. Prefer to play it safe.
Okay, Damsel Doggy's kind of trapped over to the left and require another bomb.
Okay.
But I'm down to the bottom level, just scouting things out.
Oh man,
out.
You're making good time.
Well, I took the shortcut. Let's see.
And you have the eyes on the shopkeeper yet?
I do not. There's some tiki traps in the way. I think I'm going to use...
I'm going to bomb the second one.
Oh crap,
one.
Let's not do that. I threw a bomb in the wrong spot.
Okay, if you bomb the second tiki trap on the bottom and then stand where it was, you have a straight shot to the shopkeeper.
Okay, great. That's what I'm doing now. His gun has flown away.
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking for
telltale
signs
again.
Of blood. Oh, he picked the gun back up.
Oh, man.
Resilient shopkeeper.
You've got a feisty one over there.
That's right. Gun's back on the ground. And he's dead. Okay.
Cool. I am in the exit.
And I am also in the exit.
All right.
And yeah, neither of us heard the... ticks, so
true. I did not pay enough attention to that, but I guess if we were on kind of
covering
different sections,
I think we
of the
would
map
have covered everything.
Yep. You ready?
3, 2, 1, go.
All right, let's see what we've got for 2-2 here. There's an idol. I'm gonna go off.
You pay
the
for
right.
Crimes.
I beg to differ. I think I'm gonna get away with them, actually.
All right, I see Damsel Doggy at the top right. He'll be available from other directions.
Yep, if we climb our way up there.
I won't worry about the idol.
The,
oh, I get tick, yep.
Yep. And where
I guess it's probably down by the vaults?
I don't know. I'm not getting many more ticks. Oh, no, I think I am. It's probably really
lake.
Buried.
I think I'm actually going to grab the idol really quick and make sure it's not below the lake of the idol.
Okay. I'm going to start bombing down towards that vault and see if it gets a little bit closer.
Yeah, I think it's got to be in the vault.
It might even be to the right or left of the vault. There's a ton of gems in here, though.
All right, are you slightly to the left or slightly to the right?
I'm kind of going down right through
the
middle.
I think it's going to be right. Yeah, based on just where I'm hearing the ticks.
Okay, yep, you are correct. Is this going to open up the vault? I think it might. I might even go down to where that frog is hopping around and check out from there instead of accidentally unleashing this vault keeper. Kind of brave the spikes.
Okay, yeah, it's kind of just to the left of the spikes, yeah. And
get the damsel as well. Oh, we got a giant frog over here.
Right.
Oh, and I just took damage from a frog. That was not the best idea.
I think I'm not going to worry about the damsel. And yeah, just go ahead and head into the black market entrance.
Oh, okay, here it is. Gotcha. I was having trouble pinpointing it. Oh, okay, I could have just bombed down from right next
exactly.
to the tree. Drat. All right, you going through?
Yes.
All right, I took two... I should have gone back and rescued Damsel, because I took two stupid damage from frogs on that level.
Oh, I see. Yeah, I'm at 4 hearts, I think, right now.
I'm down to 3 now.
I see.
All right, 3, 2, 1, go?
Yep.
So let's get some rope action right off the bat here.
Yep, that sounds good.
And hired help just hopped his way down.
Yep. All right, I'm bombing out the floor so that they will exit downwards, hopefully, to the next level.
It's always this first section that makes it difficult. It's a little touch and go, usually.
I'm going to go ahead and even do one more.
Yeah. They don't seem to be too anxious to get at me this time.
Yeah.
There we go. One after the other. Okay, I got the two top tier guys to drop down. And we've got Spike Shoes off to the right.
All right, interestingly, I blew one of the top guys up. Oh, crap, here's the other guy.
Oh, they took out Damsel Doggy.
Oh.
Those terrible, terrible shopkeepers.
All right, the other guy fell down.
And they're beating each other up now for me.
Good job.
And there's two tiki traps on the second tier. I'm going to try to take them both out.
Okay.
Remove that from the equation. Yes. And I think I need to open up their little passageway as well. Okay, now's the part where you guys drop down.
This is non-trivial. Hmm.
Oh, they keep infighting. I enjoy that. Keep it up, guys. There you go. One of them's just taking it on the chin, though. He's taken two shotgun blasts from his buddy so far. Why are you guys not going further down? Okay, one of them has bitten the dust. I appreciate that.
Oh, boy.
Okay, I had to invest a couple bombs. Uh-oh. Okay. What are you dealing with right now?
Okay, just had a close run-in with the shopkeeper, finally got him. Still trying to get the Ankh shop over
here. Yep, I'm just starting to work on the Ankh guy. Ooh, there's a bomb frog over there that may have made this more dangerous for me. Let's get up here where it's a little safer. There's a nice ladder above that you could... Ooh, yeah, he's able to get out now.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sitting up on the ladder. Hopefully that'll keep me out of harm's
way. Oh, maybe this guy will shoot the bomb frog for me and the bomb is going to kill him?
Okay, I have...
darn it. The bomb frog didn't get him.
Oh, I have secured the Ankh. There are still guys
I'm
running around.
I'm spending a lot of bombs, but I have killed the Ankh keeper.
I'm down to 11 myself.
I'm down to 7.
Ooh, there's a... Oh, I had another guy alive still that I was not expecting
to be
alive.
A guy in the Wheel of Fortune for me. There are more bombs down there.
There's a guy on the bottom left. I think he was a second tier shopkeeper and he's trapped behind a tree, but I think he's able to get up every once in a while.
Okay, mine are all dead.
Oh, nice.
The ghost is coming.
I've got the ghost, yes. Okay, I'm
still out of tiki traps and things.
I'm gonna try to get down towards the end. I have one shopkeeper alive still.
Go ahead and kill one tiki trap with a bomb. Oh, the ghost came from the wrong direction. I didn't realize that.
Oh boy.
Darn it.
Okay, all my guys are dead. There's a lot of tiki traps. I think I'm going to make it to the exit here. I'm through.
I'm still negotiating the ghost. I'm going to go ahead and spend a rope. I've got plenty of ropes.
Yeah, mine came from the left, thankfully, so it gave me some more time.
Okay, and so it's going to take me a minute. I'm just dragging the ghost way up to the top. And
that
then
is fine. Better safe than sorry. Around.
But so far, we've done pretty good. How are you doing on hearts?
I think I'm still at 3. I don't think I took any damage there.
Kind of cornered myself with the ghost, but I just used 3 bombs to make a new way out.
an escape route.
Yeah. It was necessary. Living is definitely among my top priorities.
I'd say 3 bombs for your life is a fair trade.
Indeed, especially when I'm still carrying 18 more.
Oh, that's right. We did get that the crate there.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I made invest the a lot exit. There. All right. You ready? Press on.
Yep. 3, 2, 1. Let's continue.
All right. Well, so
you know what? Was there a cape in there that I didn't pick up?
Not that I picked up.
Okay. All right.
I would be sad if I missed one.
Yeah.
So off to the left we have Damsel Doggy, and then also a crate down below him. And the crate
has ropes. How many
bombs
you have?
I have 24 right now.
I see. Are you gonna? Did you say that it had ropes or?
Yeah, it just has ropes. Oh,
okay.
I'm just took damage from the caveman that was next to him. That could have been avoidable. So I'm going to do my best to rescue this little guy now. So I would rather not proc my Ankh sooner than I have to.
I think we've talked about this before, but proc. Explain this word.
I don't know what it stands for. Like short, obviously it's shorthand for something. But basically, like you set it off or you kind of turn it in, I suppose you could say. It's like when it gets set off, you're procking it. I don't know. That's a good question. I should like Urban Dictionary that and see what the roots are. I should know better definitions for words that I use.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay, now you're going to survive.
There is some tough things down here, and so I've elected... Oh! Took some fall damage, but I'm still alive.
Okay.
That's a dangerous moment, though. There's going to be a frog coming at me. Okay.
Yeah, there's a giant frog down a little bit past those tiki traps, and then a couple tiki men as well.
I Lots see. I ended up taking a shortcut, and I still did not like where I am.
Mm-hmm. Thankfully, I am moving Damsel Doggy forward, so I might be able to reclaim some hearts this time.
That's good.
Pop him into a little pool for let him swim around for a little bit. So I'm off on the far left, and there's a bunch of deep pools. Oh, and he's swimming around with Piranha now. Great. It's not exactly what I was planning on. Okay.
All right, I'm down at the bottom near the exits, and I see the Piranha pools, maybe.
What kind of positioning does the shopkeeper have?
He was dead. He had killed himself to tiki traps.
Okay, cool. Well, I've missed out on my... Well, maybe I should bomb the water to get the little guy. That might be worth it since I'm down to two hearts. I think I'm going to do that.
Okay.
Invest a little bit for reasons previously stated.
I went ahead to the exit.
There we go. All right, so coming back with my little doggy friend... He's going to give me wet licks.
A lot of tiki traps, so be careful.
Yeah, no kidding. They were prevalent here. Oh, and the ghost.
The ice caves. Although I would have been looking forward to them more if I had a cape or a jetpack.
Right. I really like those mobility items. At least we have the gloves,
climbing gloves, yeah. They help a lot.
All right, give me the go-ahead.
3, 2, 1, go!
All right, ice caves ho!
Oh, my goodness, we're going to get our jetpack.
Hey, ask and ye shall receive. I just have to manage to not get myself killed somehow.
All right. I was going to say, I don't have a lot of practice with these guys, but we'll see.
I'd say the main thing to worry about is reflected bullets. As long as we don't fall into that trap,
I was going to possibly, try to get above him and...
bomb your way down.
Yeah. Let's see. I guess it's right
here. I'm used
to
having pitcher's mitt by this point, too, so I keep kind of forgetting that I don't. All right, so I just blew up the three laser beams and then shotgunned him in the face, and I'm going to bomb open the jetpack.
Okay, I just got above him and bombed, so I think the alien lord is dead.
All right.
Yeah, he is dead. I still need to spend another bomb to get my jetpack. Oops, let's not have the bomb explode, Brian.
The damsel doggy should be pretty easy to rescue here. I'm A-okay with that. He's on the right-hand side on a ledge. And let's see where our shopkeeper is. That is the bottom of the floor.
Got the jetpack.
Always feels so good when you get that. Feel like you can do anything.
Got spiky boots, but I need to worry about this thing.
Right. Okay, shopkeeper, you need to work your way out of there, please. Please and thank you. He's kind of got himself trapped on the left-hand side. He's not... Jumping off into the abyss.
Oh, compass yet.
True. That's another thing we don't have. We haven't really come across many good items. Like in the black market, didn't really.
Yeah, I'm glad we got the alien lord.
Yes, that is a big turnaround. Oh yeah, we were just talking before recording about the 720 daily we both played and how there were 5 or 6 jetpacks or something.
We counted at least 5, and I wonder if we missed one because they were just everywhere. It was ridiculous.
Yeah, because there was one in the mines somewhere. There were 2 in the black market, and then there were 2 different alien lords in the ice caves. So jetpacks, left, right, and center, basically.
Yep.
All right, I am sitting in the exit whenever you are ready.
All right, I just got the shopkeeper out of the way. I'm going to go fetch Damsel Doggy.
All right.
Hey, buddy. I'm glad I didn't shoot you in the face earlier.
Besides some of those late game items not showing up very early on, this has been a pretty decent seed. Like, there's been a number of damsels we're able to rescue, and... Nothing too terrible to deal with, thankfully. No dark levels, at least.
Oh, yeah, I didn't even think about the fact that we haven't had dark levels. Mm-hmm. All right, I've reached the exit.
All right.
Do the countdown, sir.
3, 2, and 1, and then go. And then for people who are watching who may not be familiar with Frozlunky, there are a lot of kind of built-in mod-type things you can use as well. And Brian has shown off some of that in videos on his channel. But basically, you can make the game more difficult, or I haven't even looked through the full list of what's available, but...
Yeah, I haven't really either, but yeah, you can make the game, for example, so that kind of every square on the board rather than just occasionally there being a gem in the wall or an item in the wall. You can make it so that like every square in the wall contains jetpacks and all kinds of other crazy items.
So basically you have every item you could want by the end of 1-1 is what it looked
it's
like.
It's pretty ridiculous.
The exit is the very bottom left.
Okay, and there is a doggy in the middle left.
And it's right underneath him. I think I'll be able to anger the shopkeeper and then get him to run off the ledge to the right. I believe that is the case.
Sounds good.
Is there a vault here? Because I still hear guys running around.
I haven't seen the vault yet, but I haven't explored kind of the middle or bottom right.
There is a vault off to the right-hand side. Okay, so I should be in the clear. Famous last words. Let's go get that cute little dog. And this will bring me up to 5 hearts. And I don't think there's any reason to ghost a vault today, do you?
Nope.
The temptation is there.
Tempting is though. Yep.
So I say we move on to 3-3.
All right, I'm still fetching the dog.
Now, question for you, query, I should say. Do you feel like going to the mothership or just going kind of a vanilla hell run?
They're both tempting. Mm-hmm. Which do you prefer?
I would say because longevity is our goal that we skip the mothership.
Okay, that's fair.
So I have met my end there many times.
All right, so we're getting to 3-3. Oh, I went ahead and 3-3 now.
Oh, okay.
I presume the Moai head. Yep, there's the Moai head.
Oh, right. That is a thing we need to do. Okay. So the pressure is off. Oh, we have an altar here with a little guy right underneath it. Now, I know you are probably averse to putting the little dog on that altar, but I think I don't have any moral obligation not to.
Fair enough.
And all I got for it was spring shoes, so I'm not sure if that was worth his life, honestly. I'm not sure what I was expecting to get, but
I almost killed myself early there. Yeah, I think basically if you don't have paste, you always get paste, and then after that you get one of the random items that's not the jetpack.
Mm-hmm.
And then if you have all the items, then the jetpack, and then if you have those, I'm not sure what happens in terms of loot after that.
That's a good question. If you already have everything possible, what do you
get? I came very close to being there in the 720 daily, actually.
Oh, really?
All right, the shopkeeper by the exit is bouncing up and down like a dummy.
Yep, I saw that. I'm going to see there's a... Oh, no, never mind. The UFO's turned around. He blew something up and then took care of himself.
Okay, I got the shopkeeper.
I want to mention something.
Oh,
do you have
sure.
different music right now for this level? I don't know if I've ever heard this
music. Yes.
I've either never paid attention to it or I don't know if I've ever had this music before. It's very calming
kind
of mellow.
It's the rarest.
I just about fell into the void for no good reason at all.
other than rescuing the damsel, then you're going to have to do that anyway.
Yeah, I suppose. Oh, yeah, speaking of which, where is that damsel of you?
I saw him earlier.
Oh, that's right. I sacrificed
him. And then
I've
forgotten that. Oh, yeah, there he is. Over by the Moai.
That was this level
by
sacrificed.
By the what do you call, right?
Memory of a goldfish, I tell ya. All right, so I guess I leave my shotgun behind and I go plummeting into the void. Because I don't really care about cash or anything, or ghosting. All right. There was one time I was having a really good gold run. I had already used my Ankh, though. And then I kept playing like I still had it, so I just dropped myself into the void without even thinking about it. And then when I didn't respawn is when I realized something was up. Not my finest moment.
I have a head jet. I've gone through the exit.
Say it. So have I. 3, 2, 1, move on.
All right. I'm at 109,000 at this point.
That's a good question. I am at 94,700. Well done, sir.
Apparently I've been luckier with the gems.
Or just paying more attention, which is probably likely.
Let's see. The mothership has an alien guarding the exit, but we're not going through that exit, so it doesn't matter.
I just saw that as well. There is an idol we could have. Oh, there is a shopkeeper underneath the entrance to the ship.
I see. Wonder if I can.
See. He's got a lot of bombs in there too.
Oh, that kind of shopkeeper. I see him now.
Yeah. Okay. So
he's already jumped out of the world for me.
Huh? They just alerted for me. I was hoping to kill one of them and get their. The guy left his shotgun at the exit for me.
Oh, that's
nice guy.
Is the exit below the shop or where is it?
Pretty much. Yeah.
Doesn't look like they left me anything.
Aw, my shopkeepers like me better than yours do.
I guess so.
I don't know. I guess I should look for little doggy.
I hear him to the right.
Okay. Oh, yep, I see him.
Yeah, he's to the right of the exit.
He's got a UFO with him. Let's get that guy out of there.
Yeah, let's see.
No abducting the doggy. Alright, so that will bring me back up. Wait, I thought I was at 5. When did I take damage? All right, back up to 5 now at least. And
oh
I
boy.
Guess
okay.
I'm clear Destroyed to move on that. From here. There is another crate, but it's being guarded by a UFO right next to the exit. Eh, I'm pretty set for bombs.
Shotgun. I've got plenty of bombs too. I am going to bomb this crate from the top
that
and
would
see
be
if
worth
I can get
the
alien
you.
Out of here. Okay, the alien's out, and the crate contains just more bombs.
Oh. Well, at least it's a net positive. And I'm ready to go into the
dying.
Temple.
Okay. And now I need to get the exit. Okay. 32 bombs, 16 ropes, 6 hearts with a lick from Damsel Doggy, but no shotgun.
Ooh, okay. So I'm
actually
going
to let you go first.
True. Ooh, there. Okay, so when you spawn in, there is a thwomp just to your left. I think it's just out of range, but I would get away from him ASAP.
So move to the right.
And then there's a thwomp down to the right as well as a mummy. A lot of stuff that I don't care for, so I'm going to bomb that thwomp. All right. Get out of my life, guy. Man, another vault. A spitter snake on top of a tiki trap, and then a scorpion right behind him. These are not very friendly places.
Yes.
Oh, and then Anubis is past the... Oh, I just took damage from that scorpion. Anubis is past the scorpion. He's kind of stuck behind a wall, so you can shotgun really easily. And then...
Oh, you can shotgun him.
Oh, right. Well, he should be sticky bombable as well.
Yeah.
Now, after that, there's a drop to a lava pool with a thwomp right next to that. So a lot of badness. Oh, and that's not where I want to put a bomb. Drat.
Okay, yeah, I see that crazy lava pool. Where'd you say Anubis was? Was he the bottom right?
No, he was just to the left past where the scorpion was.
Oh, okay.
For me.
All right, I just haven't found him yet, but I haven't gone past the scorpion. Darn it, I took damage from the scorpion.
He got us both. What a guy. I was sitting there waiting
for Anubis.
I was waiting for a couple different movements because I didn't want him to get me, and he still managed to get me anyway. All right, so I've angered the shopkeeper.
I've angered the shopkeepers as well. I think possibly a scepter fell on the shopkeeper's head, which worries me. Ooh. Oh, no, good. Okay.
I might just... Okay, there is... How do I want to play this one? There's a couple arrow traps down there that I'm concerned about, and I don't know how to get to the shopkeeper the best. I'm always so worried about using the scepter because it can just turn on you on a dime and then all of a sudden you're dead. All right, I'm going to spend a bomb to rescue the damsel or drop him in lava. Never mind. Didn't want to rescue him anyway.
All right, I think I'm just going to run to the exit with the scepter.
Yep, same here. I'm through the exit with 4 hearts.
I'm through the exit with 5 hearts.
Oh. All right, you ready?
3, 2, 1, let's go.
All right. Jetpack and scepter, and then a damsel right at the beginning here. There's a
Kali altar at the bottom right.
Oh, there's a thwomp on the far side of the lava pool we start next to.
Okay, good.
And actually, because there is that altar and I've already sacrificed one damsel, I think I'm going to do a second.
You monster!
And I'm going to do it again, and I'll like it. All right, so that is a Kapala for me. I think because I've spent a bomb to get down here, I'm just going to use that as a shortcut as well and not deal with that second floor.
A shopkeeper seems to be kind of down in the middle. I didn't actually see him, but I heard him firing his...
Oh, he's angry at you already, huh?
Crazy weapon, apparently so.
Huh, interesting.
I'm kind of slowly scoping out this level. I haven't figured out where the City of Gold entrance is yet. There's the shopkeeper. Okay, so the entrance is kind of bottom middle, or the exit.
Okay.
But where is the City of Gold? That's just the normal exit where the shopkeeper was.
Right. I'm taking some time to deal with a mummy.
Okay, shopkeeper killed himself somehow.
Ooh, if you go down through the center, there's a drop down to the exit. Did you see the thwomp and the scorpion and the arrow trap all hanging out together?
Yeah, there's a croc man and kind of below the Kali altar over here.
Okay.
Still haven't found the City of Gold. It must be the bottom right, I guess. Or the top right. I don't see the top right.
I'm going to bomb through to the right because I don't want to deal with any of that stuff I just mentioned. Very bad
stuff. I don't want to deal with any of this. There's a fair amount of...
You'd have to spend some bombs to get through there safely anyway.
Yeah, I'm going to spend some bombs, actually, to get through that.
Yeah, there's that croc man. Is there, like, a surefire way to kill the croc men?
I don't think so. I don't
if
know
there is, I don't know of it.
I usually, just try to get lucky.
Okay, he just... The mummy made him teleport, and it scared the pants off me, basically.
All right, so have you found City of Gold yet? I can't find it anywhere.
No. It is supposed to be on this level, right? Like, I'm not forgetting something?
Could it be at the bottom left?
I'm at the very bottom right, and I don't see it. I'm going to start working my way over to the left.
Okay, I just remember. Oh, the Hawkman with scepter, so it's not...
Yeah, shopkeeper has met his demise already. Man, where is it? It can't be buried or anything, can it?
Like, could a block have fallen in front of it? Could it be way back up at the top left somewhere where we just missed it?
The bottom left is just solid wall with some gems in it and stuff.
This is pretty weird.
I am shocked. I'm going to head back up towards the top and see if
I
missed it
somewhere.
Yeah, I'm
looking back at the top left now.
Yeah, I don't
think it's at the top left. It's at the top left.
Okay, I'm heading
up
there.
And Damsel Doggy just saved me because I fired the scepter.
There's a thwomp
needlessly,
right there.
And Damsel Doggy took the scepter thingy. So it is at the top left.
Oh, man.
The ghost is coming after me.
Oh, I should... Okay, I use the scepter. I'm going to take the time to go down and
get the
shotgun.
Yeah, I'm going to do that, too.
I almost forgot about that, but I usually like to do that.
I'm glad you said it, too.
And where is that? Okay, it's right here.
There's the shotgun.
I haven't seen my ghost. Oh, there's the ghost. Okay. So, ghost, you just mind your own business. I want to go about my own.
Man, I came pretty close to the ghost there. That was nerve-wracking.
So, have you taken care of that thwomp up towards where the golden door is?
Yes, I've gone through the door with the shotgun.
Gotcha. All right, I have as well. 3, 2, 1, City of Gold.
Woohoo! This is working pretty well.
It is. I'm pleased with this. Whoa, okay, stuff is flying around.
That was scary.
Right off the bat, making sure we're awake and all that.
That's right. I'm starting by going to the right.
Oh, I'm doing the same.
Okay.
There's a couple...
Great minds.
A couple flying, skittering things.
Yeah, don't like the lava pool over here.
Yeah.
In fact, I think I'm gonna bomb it.
And as usual, there are a few mummies right around the Necronomicon.
Okay, got rid of most of the lava.
Yeah, I'm gonna start working my way into the Necronomicon area.
Okay, there is on the left of the Necronomicon, there's two mummies and there's also a thwomp trap, so be careful there.
I'm on the right hand side of it, so I don't have to concern myself with those things.
Okay. Yeah, maybe I should go to the right hand side. Well, there's mummies
over
there.
I'd recommend it. Yeah, I'm guessing the spawning of this area always has two mummies on either side, because it seems like that's
always the case. I feel like
I'm
sometimes aware that's not the case, maybe I'm making it up. I'm not sure.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and get Anubis 2 going and give him the business end of my shotgun.
Sounds like a plan.
There we go. He is deceased. I'm going to start working my way down.
Blammo! Kablammo! Kablizzle! Beblop.
So when you get down to the bottom right, there's kind of a big open stretch that leads towards the exit. I'm going to try to maybe open that up a little bit. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do at all. I don't have a great way to deal with the shopkeeper here, which concerns me.
I haven't seen where the shop might be yet.
He's getting him. Oh, okay, he got himself killed. Thanks, buddy. Ooh.
Oh, I see the shopkeeper.
There is a mummy underneath the exit that could send some bugs your way. If
okay,
you're not
good
careful.
To know. Good to know.
And then there's a hawkman and some cavemen and all kinds of friends.
Yeah, there's a bunch of living things over here.
Yeah.
Can I get a second scepter, please? Oh, crap. Yeah. I angered the shopkeeper, so now I'm just firing madly and hoping that he finds his. Okay, they just dropped a shotgun.
Godspeed to you.
All right, shopkeeper down.
All right. Still I would not go past. I wouldn't go past the exit because there's a thwomp along the floor.
I have just gone to the exit then.
Okay. I'm sitting in the exit as well.
Okay. Whew.
Deep breaths. We're going to go to Olmec. And I think we have enough bombs to deal with him pretty easily. So I'm not too worried about this.
I don't remember how many bombs I have. I think I have like 15 or something.
Okay. Well, ready?
Yep. 3, 2, 1, go.
3, 2, 1, carry on. Okay. So hopefully we'll have a decent amount of stuff up top for us. Some extra bombs never hurt.
This collab's going pretty good.
I would say so. Have you beaten Olmec yet? Or not Olmec, beaten Yama at this point yet?
I have not beaten Yama.
Okay. Would you want a collab like this to be the first time you do, or would you rather have it a legitimate,
I still think
like,
my chances are pretty small. I don't have much experience in Hell. I've only been there a handful of times.
Yeah, I suppose Hell is the hard part, but once you actually do get to Yama, there's pretty easy, repeatable
I've gotten
way.
To Yama 2 or 3 times and managed to die.
Well, I will share the secrets with you today once we get there, and you won't be so worried about it anymore.
There is a
compass finally up at the top right.
Yeah, I just got that. And the parachute as well. That was totally worth the bomb.
Sounds like we're doing basically the same thing.
Looting the ceiling.
So the book is munching pretty fast, looks like right in the center of the map here.
Okay.
More or less. So I think I'm going to bring this guy over to the left-hand side and let him chill out there for a little bit. I remember one instance earlier on when I was playing Splunky where I was riding Olmec and there was a very low-lying ceiling that he squished me against.
Oh, and that's a bummer.
I did not enjoy that at all. It was not what I was expecting. All right.
I had a very glitchy one sometime not too long ago. I don't remember exactly what happened, but Olmec did something crazy.
Hmm. He tends to do that, I've noticed. A lot of hopping around and smashing things and just general bad behavior.
Okay, so it seems like it's here, and I have 23 bombs, so I will go 1, 2.
Still no pitcher's mitt after all this time. I am surprised.
1, 2, 3.
Ooh, I almost forgot to turn on my jetpack when I was dropping down. All right, I think...
Details.
I think if I aim him properly, I'll be able to get him down this hole. Whoop. And I've got 18 bombs on me right now. Feeling pretty good. Oh, he goes down, and I'm through.
All right, give me
a
moment.
I'm always so
here.
Worried about getting hit by a lava man when I'm down there.
I'm going to... let's keep this close enough to where I can get it far enough that if I make a mistake... Okay, I'm trying to lure him over to my hole.
All right.
Oh, no. Dear. Okay.
Oh,
I
boy.
Need to circle him back around.
Don't scare me like that.
I failed to do my little tippy toes on the edge, and as a result,
ooh,
he didn't jump down into my hole, and he just kind of jumped past it.
You have a shotgun again at this point, right?
I do have a shotgun again.
So we're back to pretty much even between the two of
us.
And we are on the highway to hell.
Okay, please. There we go. Okay.
Huh. So I'm sitting at the screen here, and I notice it says layer completed. So that's the level that
Olmec's layer
is
on. Yep.
Cool. All right. Are you there?
I am there.
All right. Let's do this. 3, 2, 1. Hell.
Woohoo! I have 243,000. That is 3 to the 5th.
Oh wow. I'm 241 right now. So still managing to keep ahead.
Okay. The blue devil on the left killed himself. Do you go after the amulet?
I do.
Okay.
I absolutely do. Especially because with the final level, there's a lot of lava underneath the floor, so I like to have that in my back pocket. And then I'm pretty sure the damsel right above the amulet is the succubus.
Fake. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that did not drop down to a place I wanted it to.
Okay, mine just dropped down as well. I still have the bats or Vlad or whoever this is.
Yeah, I bombed
Should I bomb
him.
Them? Or
I managed to bomb both of them at once and then just drop down and shotgun the other guy.
I've got the jetpack, I think, is better than his... Thingies.
Yeah, I think it's only a triple jump or something. I never replace it.
Okay.
Never replace the
jetpack
with
it. I just dropped my shotgun. Okay, this is going to be a little dodgy now.
All right. Well, I have the amulet, and I'm going to start pressing to the left.
Why is that bat not waking up? He's making me nervous.
Good level nervous?
Yeah, maybe, actually.
The shopkeeper is dead because he's got a lot of spike balls smacking him.
Ooh, okay.
Ooh.
Okay, where is... Oh, right, I have a compass. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yep, down to the left. So once you're leaving that castle-y area, there's a chain you could follow down. That's kind of a shortcut.
Okay.
I am down to 13 bombs.
Yeah, I'm down to 11 bombs now.
And I'm wondering how I want to deal with these spikes at the end. I think I might invest a bomb... And then try to get the heck away so they don't...
Did you get the crate, did you say?
No, I did not.
Okay.
Yeah, we're going to bomb that and then get away so the spike
the crate
ball...
crate is just ropes.
Okay.
I'm going to spend another bomb here.
I killed one spike trap, and I think that's probably enough to get me through. And I'm through with 11 bombs. And I have not been utilizing my Kapala that I worked so hard to get. I need to keep my head in the game here.
Okay, I should be able to do this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh, I just went right past those bombs. I wanted to pick them up.
Oh, there's bombs.
There were some bombs, like, sitting in a bag somewhere.
I could use that.
Not sure. It was just 3. That's better than nothing.
Yeah.
I'm still... Okay, the ghost is going to be coming soon. I'm going to at least get the ghost from the left. He said the shopkeepers should already dead.
The exit's on the left.
Yeah, the exit's on the left. Sorry, I want to get the ghost coming from the right. I guess the ghost is about to come. Okay.
As long as we can make these bombs last until we get to King Yam, and then we're guaranteed another two bomb boxes from those critters that spawn.
And did you bomb the spikes? Is that what you said?
I managed to kill one of the spike balls and then just avoided the second one.
Okay. I'm going to try to do that.
My brain couldn't parse the motions of both of them.
Too much.
May the force be with you, Brian.
Oh, did I get it? I think I'm okay. Whew. Yes, okay. I saw the shopkeeper's dead corpse was there, and as I walked through the door, the shopkeeper got hit by the spiky ball and bounced. Ooh. And I thought it was me for a second, and it really scared me.
Oh, man, so you made it just by the skin of your teeth, huh?
Yep.
Yikes. All right, so you're through, though?
Yep.
All right, 3, 2, 1, go. We are getting towards the end here.
I've dashed 2, baby. Got 11 bombs left.
Let's see. There's a crate off to the right.
But it's kind of scary to get.
There's a crate in the top
left. Oh, yeah.
Bomb bag.
Bombs. Hey, okay.
I will take that any day of the week.
Even Sunday?
Even Sunday. Because I just did.
Okay, you can't jump on the blue devil's heads, right?
No.
Okay.
I haven't.
Oh, and they jump up at you.
Yeah, I haven't dealt with them enough to really know what they do, so I'm going to go along the wall.
Yeah, be careful.
Down to the left.
They're scary buggers.
Yeah.
Okay, they're kind of like mini thwomps. The bottom right. I think I'm going to use another bomb to get through the lava pool and get down here.
Okay, I'm going down along the left-hand side, so I'll let you know
how that goes. Going kind of a different way.
There is another lava pool here.
There's a shopkeeper. I don't see him yet.
But remember, we don't need to be worried about lava.
Oh, right. I forgot about that. I've never been lava immune.
In fact, a lava man just dropped on my head and gave me a heart attack.
Oh,
boy. Okay. Hold on, Brian. Hold on.
It's rough.
Okay, purple guy. There we go. Shotgun you. Oh, okay. So when you get to the exit, there is one of those little devils that you could shoot, and he will drop his lava on the guy.
Yep.
And yep, it kills him. Beautiful.
Okay, unfortunately, some good teamwork there. I'm kind of in a little bit of a different situation here.
All right.
But it worked.
Awesome.
Oh man, that fire guy, yeah, like totally annihilates the shopkeeper.
He does work on that guy, yep.
Yes, work.
All right, I am through safely.
I am also safely through.
All right.
My heart is beating.
I'm excited to see how these levels have gone for you, because you've had a couple parts where you scare me. You make me feel that you've died or something.
Yep.
All right, so we need to make it through one more level of hell, and then it's on to the big guy. So, ready, set, go.
Woohoo.
If we coach each other through this, I don't see why we couldn't do it. So we've got... Oh, I just dropped my shotgun. That was not the right thing to do.
Shopkeeper's angry, apparently.
Mine is not, strangely. I'm a little worried about these spikes here.
Yeah, I am too, because there's some guys right past them.
I'm going to use some bombs. I don't, like... There's not a lot of clearance for flying above them, so I'm just not even going to risk it. I'm going to use a bomb and then go down below.
Okay, that sounds like a good idea.
I don't need that in my life right now. Okay, then there's a pretty straight shot going down.
Someone's got to make fan art of the list of things that Cthulhu needs in his life.
And it has
spikes like crossed off the list.
Oh, okay, my shopkeeper finally got spiked to death.
Very nice, very nice.
Except for that one little hoppy guy. I don't even know what kind of guy that is, really. But he's dead.
It's,
okay.
Zhang Shi.
Oh, we'll go with that then.
Yeah, all right, I'm just going to go the exit.
Yep, I'm through the exit as well.
Neat.
Okay, so... when you spawn in, you're probably familiar, there's like horse head and ox head and whatnot. So you take them out, and then every once in a while, Yama will smack against the ceiling and make stuff drop down, which is bad, obviously.
Right.
So as long as you're underneath something, you should be good.
Right.
So let's hop in and deal with that at least. 3, 2, 1, go.
So just I know you can bomb the bottom of the tiki traps to make all the tiki traps on the side go away.
Exactly, yeah. I usually save that to the end when everything's nice and safe.
I see.
More out of habit than anything else, I always go off to the right-hand side to start things off. Maybe because I'm right-handed or something. But basically all I do...
I'm okay.
Killed the guys. Are you...
Killed the guys. I had a Zhang Shi jump down onto my head.
So as you work your way up, whichever direction you decide to go, bomb whatever spikes you see.
Right.
Because you don't need them in your life. There's a couple bats. And then... Okay, so get yourself up some chains while being underneath some earth, and then get up towards the top a little ways, and I'll show you what to do or tell you what to do. And let me know when you're up there.
Okay. Took out some spikes. Mm-hmm. Okay, I can see Yama's fists. I'm hanging on a chain below a thing. Okay.
So you see the big chain going all the way up to the top?
On the left-hand side, yes.
Oh, okay, you're on the left hand. Well, basically there should be like a little spit of the brick stuff kind of off on its own closer to Yama. Do you see that?
Oh, hold on. Okay, he's shooting at me. Okay. Oh, should I go around to the right side? I don't
understand. You can, yeah. It's pretty safe on the right hand side.
Okay,
there's just one.
Go check out the right hand side.
There's one spike. Oh, I see a vampire hopping around. I was not expecting. Yeah, as long as you're underneath stuff, there's really not much besides critters to worry about on these levels. So yeah,
okay, here comes the bat.
Work your way up some chains.
Okay, bat down. Here comes another bat. Oh, get underneath. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, now right. I'm over here. I'm by the big chain.
Yep, so right above you, there's a big chunk of brick attached to the wall, and then the chain, and then there's the one thick piece of brick after that. Put a rope right underneath that one thick part.
Oh.
And then
brilliant.
You bomb the bottom of that and then back off, and then you put another rope right above the one you first placed to get up a little bit higher.
Gotcha.
And then you can basically sit right where the connection of the two ropes is and just shotgun like crazy, and he will die. And the head can't get you, he can't drop anything on you, and it's basically a guaranteed win.
Okay, did you say sit like right below the at the top, or like do I shoot at his fists or his face, or where am I aiming?
Well, first you shoot the fists, and then once the head comes, if you get up too high, he just smashes against the ceiling.
Gotcha.
So somewhere right around where the connection of the two different ropes is, you can kind of finagle it a little bit, but you're basically impervious right there.
Interesting. Oh, yeah. I just heard the door open.
There you go. And then
I'm gonna get two achievements.
Oh, two?
I get unlocking Yang and defeating Yama, completing the game the hard way.
So for good measure, I might go ahead and get some of these rubies just because it feels good.
Hmm.
Even though it doesn't really matter. It doesn't matter.
I'm not gonna bother.
I've got a low score right now, and it's not gonna be counted towards anything anyway. So
right, yeah, with Frozlunky disables the scoreboard.
Exactly. So there you go. You have defeated King Yama.
Woohoo! With the help of my friend Cthulhu.
Yay!
I couldn't have done it without you.
And like I said, once you find that little sweet spot, it's pretty much a guaranteed
thing. Yeah, that seems like a really good thing to know for the future.
Yeah.
Greetings, fellow treasure hunter. I'm Yang. It seems you have my journal with you. By now, it must be filled with all sorts of amazing things. Since you worked so hard to get here, I bet you're expecting a large reward. Well, with all the time I spent down here, I've come to realize a few things. That the journey is its own reward, and mastery is the greatest treasure of them all.
Aww. So heartwarming.
It is heartwarming. Well, okay, some gold is pretty nice too.
Yeah.
It's a giant treasure.
Isn't it awesome? Yang sitting on top of the giant pot of gold, and you get 100,000 just for the pleasure of defeating King Yama. So there we go. We beat the game in 40 minutes.
That was in our first try on camera, like doing this collab kind of thing. That felt good.
And the only practicing we did was just goofy, quick little science practicing.
Right. So yeah, making sure we had the same version of Frozlunky and all that kind of stuff.
It goes to show that with a little teamwork and friendship, you can do anything if you set your mind to it. And now you get all
kinds of
cool
fireworks. I ended up with 377,575.
Oh, I didn't even check. Let me skip the cutscene there. What did I just get? Player stats. I think you probably beat me. 370,700.
Okay, so pretty close.
Yeah, but I had a Kapala, so you know, obviously. A Kapala I basically did not even use.
Oh, there's fireworks.
Yep.
In the cutscene afterwards, and it's at nighttime, whereas I think when you defeat Olmec, I guess it's in the daytime and there aren't fireworks.
I think you're right. And then you've got the two cavemen carrying the big pot for you.
Yeah, and then Yang is on top. Yep. Oh, and then the balloons, right. I've seen this on other people's. There's crazy balloons with a caveman and a caveman balloon and all kinds of stuff.
So I'm looking at my player stats now. I've had 15 wins and then 11 special wins. So you should now have one special win on your player stats page.
I see. This is wins or Olmec, and then the special wins are that. Okay,
it's the
secret
ending, basically.
Let's go to player stats.
I'm surprised that's all I've had. I guess I've been doing mostly daily challenges
lately.
Plays
1,017, deaths 1,010, wins 7, special wins 1.
There you go.
Best score, 1,600,000.
I've gotten so close a couple times. Ugh, I just can't do it.
Last game played, 5-4. Killed by old age.
Yep.
Awesome.
I did not realize you've played so much more than me. I'm at 232 plays.
What?
Yeah.
What?
232. I guess I do have this on my laptop as well, and I think it has a different save file there. So some of my plays, maybe a third of them, are going to be over there.
Oh, man.
But still,
it
you've got...
It only took you 200 to get as good as you are?
I wouldn't go so far as to say that. But I watched a ton of LPs of this game before I even bought it. So I knew all about, like,
I see. Yeah, I started playing it blind at the beginning, and mm-hmm. so I'm sure I died a whole lot more as a result of that.
It was
enough
really
to where I rage quit after playing it for a month.
It was really fun watching you learn the game, because I'd probably watch stuff for a year before you started mm-hmm. playing. And then, I don't know, it's kind of the same way with Binding of Isaac for me, where I see people learning it, I kind of enjoy the newness
of
the game.
Yeah,
all
maybe
over
at some
again.
Point I'll finally pick that game up and do a blind LP of it, because I've really not watched anybody play the game. And
before
so
long, what... they're coming out with a rebirth, is what it's called. So it's going to have a full graphical overhaul and then a ton of new stuff added onto it. Basically, a brand new game. So maybe when that comes out, and there should be seeded runs on that as well. So just throwing that out there.
I see.
Well, sounds anyway, this has been fun. I'm glad this worked out so well. I was hoping it would, and I was not disappointed.
It totally did. Yeah, I hope people enjoy watching us play together on Frozlunky Spelunky. And yeah, by all means, if you haven't checked out Cthulhu, he's playing Spelunky and a bunch of other games on his channel. So mm-hmm. go check him out. There'll be a link in the description.
And vice versa, if for some reason you guys haven't subscribed to Loregon yet, which would be a horrible mistake on your parts. So yeah, thanks everybody for watching. And maybe we'll do some more Frozlunky stuff with people in the future. Let me know what you guys think.